In this talk, I'll focus on the inner loops of the butterfly diagram. Those are the smaller loops about maintenance, reuse, and remanufacturing. The smaller the loop, the greater the profitability of the overall system. For instance, if I repair a product instead of having it recycled, I am saving a lot of resources and energy. So keeping a product at its highest value for as long as possible makes sense, both from an economic and an ecological perspective. So this means that it's worthwhile to postpone the moment that a product is recycled for as long as possible. And we often joke that recycling is the last resort option. The inner loops of the butterfly diagram are essentially about product life extension, making products last longer. Basically, there are two ways to extend the life of products. The first is to keep them in use for longer, and the second is to give products a second life, third life, fourth life, etc. So in order to keep products in use longer, the first option, it makes sense to design them to be really durable. And we can also use maintenance and upgrade to achieve the same goal. Look at the case study of Fairphone, for instance. Their latest phone was designed to be maintained and upgraded. If we want to give products a second or third life, which is the second option for product life extension, there are other strategies: repair, refurbishment, and remanufacture. You can repair a product yourself, and we'll be trying this later, or you can have it repaired. Refurbishment is a more extensive process where products are repaired and components replaced in order to bring it back to a satisfactory working condition. And refurbishment is always done in a commercial enterprise. For instance, you can now buy refurbished smartphones. Remanufacture is an even more extensive process. Here, products are totally disassembled into components, and those components are brought back to the original quality and then used to manufacture new products that are identical to the original products. So you can see that if you look at repair, refurbishment, and remanufacture, the process becomes increasingly complex, involving more and more product disassembly and reassembly. But all three activities result in giving products a second life. Now, is product life extension always a good idea? In general, I would say yes, but not, for instance, if new products come along that are radically more energy efficient, making it better from an ecological perspective to replace your old energy-guzzling product rather than using it longer. Also, product life extension may be difficult for many kinds of packaging. So, there are exceptions.